Hi all, today we will discuss about the topic virtual function. So you have already studied something about virtual function. So why we need virtual function is when we use the same function name in both the base as well as in the derived class, then the function in the base class has to be declared as virtual using the keyword virtual. So when a function is made as virtual, C++ determines which function to use at the runtime rather than at the compile time. So that's how we will achieve runtime polymorphism. That is, if you want to decide which function has to be executed at the time of runtime, then you can achieve that with the help of virtual functions. So how it will determine which function has to be called, it depends upon the type of the object that has been passed to the base pointer rather than the type of the pointer. That is, I have already told you about the, you can use the base class pointer to point to a derived class object. So by seeing which object is actually being pointed by the base pointer, it will determine which function to be called at the time of runtime. That is how we will use virtual functions to achieve runtime polymorphism. So virtual function is nothing but it is a member function of the class that is declared within a base and redefined in a derived class also. So while you are defining that virtual function, you have to use the keyword virtual. Then you have to specify the return type of the function followed by the function name. And in the bracket, you can give the body of the function. So there are certain rules to be there to define a virtual function. The first rule is the virtual function must be the members of some class. If you want to define a function as a virtual function, then it has to be member of some class. And they cannot be static members. The virtual functions cannot be static members. And they has to be accessed by using object pointers. And you can make virtual function as a friend of another class, or you can use a virtual function in the base class and it cannot be used even in the derived class. That is, if you have defined a function as virtual in base class, then it is not necessary that you should redefine that function in the derived class. If you need to redefine it, you can redefine it, or otherwise there is no rule that it has to be redefined. But there is one thing, that is the data types of the base class version of a virtual function and all the derived class versions must be identical. That is, if you have defined your virtual function data type as integer, then in the derived class versions also it has to be integer. You cannot change the data type of the base class version and the derived class version. It has to be identical. And we cannot have virtual constructors, but we can have virtual destructors. And if a virtual, as I've already said, if a virtual function is defined in the base class, it need not be necessarily redefined in the derived class. And when a base class points to a derived, base class pointer points to a derived class, incrementing or decrementing that pointer will not make it to point to the next object of the derived class. That is actually not a rule of virtual function, but you have already studied that you can use the base class pointer to point to a derived class object. But if you are using something like that, then incrementing or decrementing that pointer will not point it to the next object of the derived class. If you want to point it to the next object of the derived class, then you have to use another pointer. By incrementing or decrementing the base class pointer, it will not point to the next object of the derived class. So these are the main roles of the virtual function. You can have virtual destructor, but you cannot have a virtual constructor. So this is an example of concept of virtual function. So here you can see that you have defined a class base, and in that you have defined a function, two functions as public functions. One is, that is the print function, is actually being defined as a, here you can see that the print function is actually being defined as virtual. And in that, inside that print function, you are just printing the data print base class. And similarly, you have another function, that is void show, which is actually printing show base class. These are the two functions in the base class. Then you have another class derived, which is publicly inheriting the base class. So in that also you have defined two function, the print function as same as that of base class, and also the show function, which is as same as your base class. But here print function is printing print derived class, and show function is printing show derived class. Here it is printing base class and show base class. Here it is print derived class and show derived class. Then in your main function, you can see that you have created a pointer to your base class, and you have obtained, or you have made a object to the derived class, that is derived D. And you have used the base class pointer to point to the derived class object. And while you are using this, that is BPTR, to call the function print, then since these function, print function, has been used as a virtual function, or be defined as a virtual function in your base class, then it will decide which function will be called at the time of runtime. And if you have used the BPTR to call the function show, then it will, since show is not declared as a virtual function, this show will be the show function of the base. That I already told you, by using the base class pointer, you can only access the properties that has been inherited from the base class to the derived class, but you cannot call the functions of the derived class. So here BPTR, by using BPTR, if you call the show function, then it will call only the base class show, not the derived class show. So but print, since it has been made as a virtual function, that will be called, or which function will be called, will be decided at the time of runtime. Okay, so that is the difference between normal functions and virtual functions. By using virtual function, you can make, or you can achieve runtime polymorphism, or which function will be called will be decided at the time of runtime rather than at the compile time. So next, another type of virtual function is pure virtual function. So pure virtual function in C++ is a virtual function for which we don't have an implementation. We only just declare that function. That is, a pure virtual function is a function declared in the base class that has no definition relative to the base class. You will just define that function, or you can just declare that function, you will not be defining that function. So in such cases, the compiler requires each derived class to either define the function or redeclare as a pure virtual function. That is, if that class has been inherited by another class, then either you have to redefine that function in the derived class, or you have to redeclare it as a pure virtual function. Then only it will allow you to inherit that type of classes. Or such classes can be said as abstract classes, and we will not be creating any object for classes containing pure virtual function. So pure virtual function will be having a virtual keyword, that here you can see that. And a pure virtual function is declared by assigning a zero in the declaration. This is actually an example of a pure virtual function. Here you can see that you have defined a virtual function and it has been assigned to 0. That will show that this class is an abstract class, and whichever class is inheriting this class has to redefine that function, or it has to redeclare it as a pure virtual function. So pure virtual function is nothing but the virtual function which is equated to 0. That is, it will not have a body. You will just declare that function, and whichever class that is inheriting that class has to redefine this function, or it has to redeclare that function as a virtual, pure virtual function. So in this example, you can see that this derived class is inheriting base class, and here the function fun is actually been redefined here. So here it is actually printing fun is called. So in your main program, you have derived or you have created an object for the derived class, and by using that object you have called the fun function. Okay, so that is what is known as pure virtual function. So next we will see virtual constructors and destructors. As I already said that the constructor cannot be virtual. So there are certain reasons for the constructors cannot be virtual. The first reason is, you already know that if you want to create an object, the constructor of the object class must be of the same type as the class. But this is not possible with a virtually implemented constructor. That is, if you want to create an object, then definitely at the time of object creation, your constructor will be called. So your constructor of the class has to be of same type as that of class. That is, whatever be the name of the class, that will be the name of your constructor. So that will not be possible if your constructor is a virtually implemented constructor. And the second reason is, at the time of calling a constructor, the virtual table would not have been created to resolve any virtual function calls. That is the next problem. That is, the constructor will be called at the time of object creation. At the time of object creation, the virtual table has actually not been formed. So that it will cannot decide which function will be called at the time of runtime. So that's why you cannot have a constructor as virtual. But you can have a destructor as virtual. Why we need a virtual destructor is, so you already know that you can use a base class pointer to point to a derived class object. So if you are deleting a derived class object using a pointer to the base class that has non-virtual destructor, it will result in undefined behavior. So we can see an example of it. So here you can see that you have a class base which is having a constructor base and a destructor base. So constructor is actually printing constructing base, and destructor is printing destructing base. And you have another class derived which is publicly inheriting base. So there also you have a constructor as well as a destructor. So in your main function, what you have done is you have created a pointer for the derived class. You can see that derived star d equal to new derived by using the new operator. And also you have created a base class pointer and have used the derived class object to it. You have assigned the derived class object to a base class pointer, and then you have deleted that base class pointer. So while you have done something like that, then this object pointer is deleted using delete operator. It will trigger the base class destructor, and the derived class destructor won't be called at all. That is, it will only destruct the base class objects but not the derived class objects, and this may lead to memory leak situation. So to make sure that the derived class destructor is called, what we will do is we will declare the base class destructor as virtual. So in this program, if you want to make the base class destructor as virtual, what we will do is, here in your program, you will make this one, that is this as virtual star base. So if you have made something like this, then if you have used delete operator to delete the base class pointer, then it will trigger both the base class destructor as well as the derived class destructor. So that is why you have to create a destructor as virtual. So we cannot have a virtual constructor, but you can have a virtual destructor. Virtual destructor is needed since you can use a base class pointer to point to a derived class object. So while doing so, if you are destructing that base class pointer, then only the base class constructor will be called, sorry, destructor will be called, and it will not call the derived class destructor. So thereby it will lead to memory leak situation. In order to avoid that, you will make the base class destructor as virtual. So that's all. I hope you have understood that.